Hej och välkommen till Genève där internationella Röda Kors och Röda Halvmånen håller sina internationella möten. Och en av de saker vi har enats om här det är att kraftsamla mot kärnvapen. Och jag står här just nu med Matt Ives som är från ungdomsförbundet i Australien. Och de har engagerat sig väldigt mycket och vi ska höra varför. Matt, why are you so engaged in the fight against the use of nuclear weapons?
Well, it comes, I guess, from a personal issue in regards to a lot of Australians. In the Pacific region, we've had a lot of testing of nuclear weapons in our area, which has actually affected a lot of people in the area. Also in regards to the Japanese, which we have a large population in our country, with the Hiroshima bomb and the Nagasaki bomb. It's something which we as young people are taught very much and very closely, and it's definitely something which we've seen the effect that it can have and the humanitarian impact that it can have on just general people.
Mm-hmm. And you have asked to carry with you a certain thing. What is that?
Yes, so this is a paper crane. It's a story, I guess, that relates to a story of Sadako, a young girl who was a 12-year-old at the time of the Hiroshima bombing. This young 12-year-old Japanese girl was affected and developed on early onset leukemia, which she was told a story though from her grandmother that if she makes 1,000 cranes, she'd get one wish. And so she started making those cranes, and before she finished making those cranes, she actually passed away at making 644 cranes. The community, after she passed away, got behind her and made a further 354 to make that 1,000 cranes. They then buried her with those cranes. Quite a touching story. I guess it's touching in two ways, is that it shows the symbolism of, firstly, the effect and the humanitarian impact that nuclear weapons, the use of nuclear weapons, can have on the general public, the community, who may not have been involved in the overall war, but they were hurt by it. Further all, it shows the community and what we can do as a community if we get behind the campaign to make nuclear weapons the target and ban the use. So this is what the youth of Australia, and supported by the youth of the Pacific, have done to make 1,000 cranes and started a competition to really emphasise how we, as the humanitarian movement of the world, can do and what we can do to make sure this ban happens. And it's amazing because at this General Assembly and the Council of Delegates, they just passed the make nuclear weapons target idea to ban the use. And so it's only early days, but it shows so many amazing things can happen if we all get together and start.
And we are hoping to help you with a few of those cranes and engage as well. Thank you very much, Matt Ives.
Thank you.